Morning, children. Welcome to class 7 science. Children, in a previous video we were discussing about chapter number 5, that is acids, bases and salt. We are doing revision. So by the use of concept map we have revised the lesson chapter 5. Now we will discuss the question answer of this chapter. Okay, so see question number 1 first. The question number 1, that is differences between acids and bases. Okay, so I think you know very well the difference, and this is very important regarding your exam. So the first difference you can see there, first of all we see the difference between acids and bases, then we'll discuss the next questions. Okay, so 3 points of acids I have written here and 3 points of base in the next slide. Okay, so see about acids first. Number 1, acids taste sour. Okay, or taste of acids is sour. Okay, acids turn blue litmus paper into red. Okay, while we use the blue litmus paper in acid, so it will turn red. Okay, next, that is acid contain hydrogen ion. Okay, acid contain hydrogen ion. So 3 points regarding acids we see here. Now base, see the base. Now the taste of bases is bitter. Okay, bases are bitter to taste, and on blue, on litmus paper, okay, it turns to blue. Litmus paper is of two types, red litmus paper, blue litmus paper. So the red litmus paper we use in testing of bases, and the blue litmus paper we use in testing of acids. So here we have taken the red litmus paper. If the red litmus paper turns to blue, that means the solution will be base. Okay, and it have hydroxyl ion. Okay, it have hydroxyl ion. Clear? Any problem regarding that? So bases, we can say that bases are bitter to taste, it is soapy to touch, and it turns red litmus paper into blue, and it have hydroxyl ion. Okay, so children, these are some differences between acids and base, that is very important regarding your exam. Okay, in the form of MCQ, many question will ask from this chapter. So you learn very carefully each and every point. Okay, next, question number 2. Question number 2, that is ammonia is found in many household products such as window cleaner. It turns red litmus paper blue. So what is nature? Okay children, I told you, that is if a red litmus paper turns to blue, that means the solution will be base. Okay, so that's why we can say here ammonia is having a basic nature. Okay, why ammonia is having a basic nature? Because it turns red litmus paper into blue. Means suppose we have a solution of ammonia there, then we want to check whether it is acid or base, so we use red litmus paper red litmus paper, then we dip the red litmus paper into the solution, then if it turns blue, that means it is base. Okay, if the litmus paper turns red, so that means it is acid. So red litmus paper turns blue, that's why it is basic in nature. Okay, next, question number 3. In question number 3, see, name the source from which litmus solution is obtained. Okay, or what is the use of this solution? Litmus solution, that is an indicator. So we have to identify from where the litmus is extracted and what is the use of litmus. Okay, see in the answer, litmus solution is extracted from lichens. Okay, lichens, and it is used to determine whether the given solution is acidic or basic. Okay, clear? It is extracted from lichen. Okay, do you know what is lichen? Lichen is a symbiotic association between algae and fungi. Okay, so from that association the litmus solution is obtained, and the use of litmus, that is to identify whether the given solution is acidic or basic. Okay, clear? Next, number four, that is distilled water acidic or basic or neutral? How would you verify it? Okay, so children, we know that distilled water neither tastes sour nor bitter, so that means it is neutral. Okay, it is neutral, so we can say here distilled water is neutral. And now how can we verify? We can verify it by showing that neither red nor blue litmus paper change its color when dip in distilled water. Okay, we use indicator to determine the nature of the solution, whether it is acid or base. So litmus solution or litmus paper we have taken, and we have dipped the litmus paper into the distilled water, then we find that it neither turns red nor blue. Okay, it doesn't show any color, it show the color of indicator only, so that means it is neutral. Okay, it doesn't showing any color, it is not red, it is not blue. Okay, clear? Any problem regarding that? Next, question number 5, that is, describe the process of neutralization with the help of an example. Neutralization reaction we also discussed in a previous video. Okay, that is very simple, very easy. Neutralization is the process in which acids and bases are react together, and both of them neutralize the effect of each other. Okay, means acid neutralize the effect of base, and the base neutralize the effect of acid. Okay, and a new substance will form there, that is salt and water. This is neutralization reaction. Okay, clear? Now see the answer. You can see on your screen the reaction which occur between acid and base is known as neutralization. Salt and water are byproduct in this process, and heat is also liberated. Okay, so salt and water, that is a product of this reaction. Some example are there, like magnesium hydroxide, baking soda, etc., which contain bases, are used to reduce acidity in our stomach. Okay, like sometime we'll take more fast food or any other reason, so our stomach contain more acids, at that time we feel acidity. Okay, so to reduce this problem, to get relief from this problem, we'll take some base like magnesium hydroxide, baking soda. So when we take base, then acids and base both neutralize the effect of each other, and we feel relief there. Okay, clear? Number 5, Now next, that is next question. Explain why the three subparts are there. First, that is an antacid tablet is taken when you suffer from acidity. Okay, this is also a part of neutralization reaction. Second, factory waste is neutralized before disposing it into a water bodies. That is also a neutralization reaction. And third part, that is calamine solution, is dipped or applied on the skin when an ant bite. Okay, so three questions that you see on your screen, these are the types of neutralization reaction. Okay, we'll discuss one by one. We'll take first, that is antacid tablet taken when we suffer from acidity. Okay, so see here, why we take antacid tablet or syrup. We take an antacid like magnesium hydroxide to neutralize the extra acid which is released in our stomach. Okay, means I give example, that is like sometime we have take more fast food, sometime we take more oily food there. Okay, then at that time we feel acidity. Okay, so due to secretion of extra acid in our stomach, we feel acidity. So to neutralize this problem, we take some base in the form of antacid tablet. Okay, in the form of tablet, in the form of syrup, we'll take when antacid tablet will take the acid and base, both neutralize the effect of each other and we get relief. Okay, next, that is factory waste is neutralized before disposing it into water bodies. Okay, so factory waste that contain acid. Okay, if the factory waste directly disposed into water bodies like river, okay, so it kill many aquatic organism. Okay, it shows some harmful effect there. So before release into the water bodies, the factory waste should be treated with bases. Okay, clear? See here, the waste which come from factories contain acid, and if this acid is dumped into water body, it harm the organism present in it. Okay, so those organism that are present in the water bodies, they will harm, they will kill. Okay, so it is necessary to neutralize this waste by adding a basic substance. Okay, clear? When acid and base both added, then they neutralize the effect of each other. Okay, next and the last types of the neutralization reaction, that is calamine solution is applied on the skin when an ant bite. So children, when an ant bite, it releases the formic acid in our skin. This formic acid cause the swelling and pain in our skin. Okay, so to get relief from the pain and swelling, we applied calamine solution on the ant site. Okay, clear? Now see once again in the answer. Ant inject formic acid into the skin by biting our skin, which cause inflammation of the skin. The effect of acid can neutralize by rubbing skin with calamine solution, which contain a base, that is zinc carbonate. Okay, when the base will apply on the ant's bite, so it neutralizes the effect of acid. Okay, clear? So that's why we applied calamine solution on the ant's bite. Okay, or baking soda we rub there. Next, that is in this question you can see there the three liquids are given. Okay, first one, that is hydrochloric acid, second sugar solution, and third, that is sodium hydroxide. Okay, so how will you identify them? You only have a turmeric indicator. Okay, we have a turmeric indicator. Indicator role we know very well, that determine the nature of the substances. Okay, so we can easily determine. So children, on acid, what is that? In acid, the turmeric indicator turns blue. Okay, and in sugar solution, that is a neutral substance, they do not show any color. And in base, the turmeric indicator turns red. Okay, so that's why we written here, turmeric indicator turns yellow to blue in hydrochloric acid. On sugar solution, it doesn't change their color, and on sodium hydroxide, it turns into red. Okay, so these are the effect of turmeric indicator on these solution. Okay, I hope you learned very carefully. Okay, so revision we have finished, that chapter number 6, will not revise. Okay, we'll start the next chapter, that is chapter number 9, in the next video. Okay.